Remember, for Jesus himself was also important to get to notice what is the will of God, and to assimilate it for his own purpose and his own life. Because we need to see, to digest, what is the meaning from the Father, what is the will of God, what is God, the Father, asking for him. When he realized that, he decided to do it, and he knew that he must go to Jerusalem. Because this is the place that he is going to show everything according to the will of God. But in the way, it's very important what we are going to learn. Because, as you will know, look in the Gospel, we use these 20 Sundays. From now on, for 20 Sundays, we show the way that Jesus is walking to Jerusalem. In his way, he will go slowly, showing and teaching the will of God. And let the apostles to understand what is the real meaning of the will of God. Because sometimes we get confused with so many ideas, and sometimes we are so in a habit to get the idea, and maybe we are not correct. This is why it is important today to understand what is the meaning to be a follower of Christ. To be a Christian, that is the meaning. To follow Christ. Because many times, in many ways, we have listened that and we say by ourselves, I am a Christian. I follow Jesus Christ. Yes, but for you, what is the meaning of that? Because it's very important, and the Gospel today shows us that kind of understanding. If you remember, how many people Christ, Jesus Christ, tell them, follow me today?
Three.
Right?
Yes.
Wrong. Only one. Only one. I mean that you were not listening to the Gospel. If you remember the Gospel today, to only one Jesus said, follow me. The other two, they said to Jesus, I will follow you. It's not Christ the one who asked them. It's them the ones who are asking Christ to let them to follow him. But in this kind of ideas, we can understand what is the meaning to follow him. If you remember in the first one, say, I will follow you wherever you go. Yes, but what is the meaning to follow him? If you understand to follow Christ, somebody who is going to be between the people that can work that, to take position, to take power, take a place, and all the people will understand that you are with Christ or something like that, you are wrong. You are wrong. Because to follow Christ is just to understand that you are nobody. That you are following him. That you are trying to do according to the life of what he is doing. And that means to serve, to be with the others, and to try to be the rest of the others. Like Christ did it. So it's not to look for position. It's not to look for rewarding. Nothing like that. That is not the idea. Follow Jesus, you must understand that you just decided, I will follow you, whatever it is. I don't know what will happen, I don't know where, I don't know what I need to do, but I am here. You remember the song that says, here I am, no? That is the form. Here I am. Whatever you want, whatever you want, and I can do whatever you want. Because the important thing is not me. Is how can I serve to be of this? That is to follow Christ. That is the meaning of that. This third one, do you remember what is that? Third. He said, I will follow you. But then Jesus said what? Because he said, I will follow you, but let me
farewell.
Yes. And I said, okay, what do you mean for that? The first meaning actually is the same point. Elisha was saying to Elijah, I will follow you. Yes, I will, but let me say goodbye to my father and mother. Then I will follow you. How Elijah answered, do you remember? You do, but you think about what I did to you. What I did to you. That means, think about what is important here. What is the meaning to call you to follow? Where do you put the importance of your life? Because it's good to say goodbye to your father and mother, but what is the main point here? That's what Elisha understood. Elisha went and said goodbye to his father and mother?
No.
Why? He asked for that. He said, I will follow you, but let me say goodbye to my father and mother. Why not? Well, how can I know that he didn't go there? How? How was written in the first reading? The first reading does not say yet anything like that. He only said that maybe he considered the priorities. It is very clear the priorities. And maybe he was thinking also the same. If I start something, but I leave something behind, I will have the temptation to come back. I always will have it that whatever happened, whatever happened, any frustration, when I don't have the security of whatever happened, I will say, oh, I need it. I go back to what I'm doing before. Elisha immediately cut that type of possibilities. He was a rich person. He has land. Actually, he has 12,000 to grow up. Plus, whatever they got, he was even has a people to do his job, and he was in charge of the 12th one. So he can do very easy to come back and enjoy life and forget about to be a prophet. You know, the prophet is always the people doesn't like you, they will attack you, they will kill you, they whatever. So, why do you need to take that? Well, you need to see the priority. What is God is asking you? And if God is asking you to be a prophet, if God is asking you to be a follower of Christ, if God is asking to be a Christian in the life, then we need to understand what is the meaning to be a Christian. What is the meaning to be a follower of Christ today? Number one. Because if we have also something behind, then we say, oh, let us see, it's not, and then I do. Peter did it. Do you remember Peter what he did? He was confused, he wasn't what to do, he doesn't know what else. He didn't say, oh, I'm going to fish. Because what about him? He knows how to do it. It's the same temptation for everybody. And that means, please, if you are a follower of Christ, cut all the temptations like Elisha. He cut everything. He doesn't have the possibility to come back. Because if he comes back, he doesn't have anything. He immediately gave everything to everyone. So he doesn't have the possibility. For us in our life, I don't know what can we do for that. Or how can we the situation to be a follower of Christ. To the second one, he said, follow me. And what he said, see what can I do. And they make, okay, without that compromise, I will do it. Before, I was also working in the vocational program. And sometimes, many young people say, Father, I want to be a missionary. Just let me finish the, my family has some needs. Let me help them. Let me get them, okay, and then I will do it. I say, thank you. We don't need you. Because you will always have the same God. Today is like that, tomorrow will be another one, and then after that will be. No. Somebody who decided to leave everything and go ahead with the capacity that God is with you, and then you are doing the will of God. And whatever happens, whatever problems come out, He will tell. It's not your problem. It's a problem of Him. But you need to have faith and confidence. And that is the meaning to be a follower of God today. How can you make that kind of translation of follower of Christ in your own life? In your own family that you are living now? When you are in the buying things in the market, and you are walking in the street, how can you show the others that you are a Christian? The Christ is with you, that you don't worry about the other problems. Yes, you know, and you need to help them, but you have confidence that He will take care of everything. That is the meaning to be there, and to understand what is to be really good. There are people who doesn't understand that they go to another way. And today the gospel is exactly the same. What happened with the people who doesn't receive Jesus and his hometown? Because they were Samaritans. And you know, Samaritans and the Jews are exactly the same family. There are brothers and sisters. There are only fighting people for the faith. And what is the problem of the faith? They say they have the same God, but they have different places to worship God. The Jews, Jerusalem, the Samaritans, other places. And if he go to Jerusalem, we don't welcome him. And then, for that reason, they didn't welcome Jesus. Will immediately become the apostles. The ones who understand Christ and the ones who are following Him with a big decision and a big solution of the problem. What is the decision? Do you remember? How they will try to make the solution of that kind of problem? Why they don't accept Jesus? Do you know? Do you remember? What is the suggestion of that?
Let the fire ring
from heaven. Yes, let us bring fire from heaven, from the sky, to do what?
To destroy them.
Finish that. Big solution. Big solution. And the second reading of today is that when you use the freedom, you never attack people. You never go against the people. When you are free, you are being free from your heart. Let the things happen, and you try to do all the kind of service. What is the will of God in this kind of situation? He doesn't want that the people finish. He doesn't want to kill everybody. Conversion to try to amend their life, not to kill them. I mean, even the apostles, they don't understand what is the really the meaning to be a Christian. And maybe today we are the same. This is why the readings of today is one invitation for us to try to understand. For me, to be a Christian, what could be the meaning? How can I be really a follower of Christ in today's life? The reason is that kind of invitation. think about them and to see today a follower of Christ, the one who understands the will of God, the one who do like Christ, do what? And I hope every one of us can answer to this. And I hope that everyone will be more clearly how to be a Christian and a better life. To understand the meaning of the way that Christ did it in the middle of the people. To serve the other, to talk to the other, to relation, to have the relation to the other in the same way. Because that is the meaning to be a Christian. Even if sometimes we don't know what is going to happen, but we know that He is with us, that He will help us. That is how we start this celebration of the ordinary life. Trying to see in our ordinary life to discover how to be a Christian in life. May God help us.